Let's dive into this tank of water.
Flippin' physics!
And visualize a hypothetical cube submerged in the water. Because pressure increases with depth, there is pressure pushing inward on all six sides of this hypothetical cube. And the forces from that pressure acting inward on all four vertical sides of the cube all cancel one another out. That leaves us with an upward force acting on the bottom side of the cube and a downward force acting on the top side of the cube. And again, because pressure increases with depth, the upward force acting on the bottom side is larger than the downward force acting on the top side. In other words, the net force acting on the cube caused by the pressure from the water acts upward on the cube. That upward net force is called the buoyant force. This buoyant force is what makes it so that when I let go of an object which is submerged in water and is less dense than water, that object accelerates upward. Now, let's jump back out of the tank of water. And then,